The dual luciferase reporter assay system is an efficient method for performing dual reporter assays. With a dual reporter assay, a primary reporter of interest can be normalized against a control, allowing increased precision. This assay allows you to quickly quantify two luciferase signals from a single sample. Before you begin, make sure you have phosphate-buffered saline, a luminometer, and a siliconized polypropylene tube or small glass vial. Prepare the passive lysis buffer by adding one volume of 5X passive lysis buffer to 4 volumes of distilled water. Mix well and store at 4 degrees Celsius for up to but no longer than 1 month. Prepare luciferase assay reagent 2 by resuspending the lyophilized luciferase assay substrate and 10 milliliters of luciferase assay buffer 2. This reagent is stable for 1 month at minus 20 degrees Celsius, or for 1 year at minus 70 degrees Celsius. Repeated freezing and thawing of this reagent may decrease its performance, so we recommend luciferase assay reagent 2 be dispensed into aliquots for each experimental use if the supplied volume is not used entirely. Prepare an adequate volume of stop-and-glow reagent to perform the desired number of DLR assays, 100 microliters of reagent per assay. Add one volume of 50X stop-and-glow substrate to 50 volumes of stop-and-glow buffer in a glass or siliconized polypropylene tube. Stop-and-glow reagent is best when prepared just before use. If stored at 22 degrees Celsius for 48 hours, the reagent's activity decreases by 8%. There are two methods for cell lysis, one recommended for passive lysis of cells in multi-well plates, and the other intended for active lysis by scraping adherent cells grown in culture dishes. Remove the growth medium from the cultured cells and gently apply a sufficient volume of phosphate-buffered saline to wash the surface of the culture vessel. Swirl the plate to remove detached cells and residual growth medium. Completely remove the rinse solution before applying passive lysis buffer reagent. Dispense into each culture well a minimum volume of passive lysis buffer to completely cover the cell monolayer. Place the culture plates on a rocking platform or orbital shaker with gentle motion to ensure complete and even coverage with 1X passive lysis buffer. Allow the plates to rock at room temperature for 15 minutes. Transfer the lysate to a tube or vial for further handling and storage. Alternatively, reporter assays may be performed directly in the plate. Because of the volumes added, this would typically only be in a 96-well plate. For active lysis, begin by removing the growth medium, then apply a sufficient volume of phosphate-buffered saline to rinse the bottom of the culture vessel. Swirl the vessel briefly to remove detached cells and residual growth medium. Completely remove the rinse solution from the culture vessel. Apply a sufficient volume of 1X passive lysis buffer to the cell layer in the culture vessel. Cells may be harvested immediately following the addition of passive lysis buffer by scraping vigorously with a disposable cell lifter or a rubber policeman. Pipette the accumulated lysate several times to obtain a homogeneous suspension. Transfer the lysate to a tube or vial for further handling and storage. Carefully transfer up to 20 microliters of cell lysate into a luminometer tube or multi-well plate. Place the plate or tube in the luminometer. Make sure you've placed the appropriate assay reagents in the luminometer and prep the injectors according to the instrument manual instructions. Run the protocol on the luminometer. A dual injector luminometer will add 100 microliters of luciferase assay reagent 2, take a reading, and then add 100 microliters of stop-and-glow reagent and take a second reading. Remove the multi-well plate once all readings have been completed. For a single-tube luminometer, insert subsequent samples until all readings are complete.